needs scrap. Fuel can. There we go. Okay. Finally. Every day. Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon?
Which way?
Maybe in one of these.
Got it.
Now I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to. I got a use for you.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing!
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
There we go.
What do we got?
What I can do.
Hold on, they're slowing down. It looks like they're stopping.
Zero. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage 3.
Sleeping with servants. And I asked if you were going. Can't be. Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was fubar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Seal the caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
How much longer do you think we got?
How the hell do I know? We'll bug out when the docks finished.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
Let me go to the farewell. The hero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you...
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
O'Brien. Wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't...
I'm not, Boozer, I'm not. I'm just... Look, get some sleep. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon.
the truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the Rose King choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they would have blown it to hell. Just so I wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon.
Damn it! Where is he? Man, that was tough. Where the hell did he go? He's here somewhere.
Now.
This shit out here again?
Oh, yeah, because they're assholes.
Here we go. That should be it.
Yep.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Man. Black helicopters have been spotted in the skies. Seen him. Heard him. Thought you were losing your mind. But you're not. They're real. And they're proof that I was right. We thought Nero died out here like the rest of them. Caving under their own stupidity. But no. Like I said, they've been lying in wait all this time till they can crawl up out of their holes. Claim this world. But it ain't happening. Not on my watch. And don't go running towards them, thinking they're gonna save your ass. Any man wearing a uniform worth a damn died more than 2 years ago. These men, they'll shoot you on sight. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus. Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit. You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy. Yeah.
Another bounty.
You go.
make something out of this. Mobile medical unit. I gotta find a way inside. See if there's another injector. Here's the generator. Feels, yes. Now we're in business. I'll let you do it. Done. And Green lights. Green lights are good.
Yes. Finally. All right. Now let's see what they got there. Another Nero Michael. Another Nero injector. Good.
Checkpoints. Waiting to die. More bounties. Infestation zone. Ooh, I smell a nest. Gotta be right here.
Finally. Jesus.
Why you like that, freak?
Huh?
Should be it.
Me and get away with it.
escape.
Who was that?
Covering fire! Covering fire!
Killing drifters, is that it? How do you like it now?
Someone's here. That's all of them.
right now. There we go.
Let's see.
Help, he's here. Damn it, lost it.
I thought I saw someone out there.
I got you. He's on my side.
Now I got you, stupid drifter.
What the hell's he doing? I know where you're at! Just hold on! Hey! Kid!
Keep moving. Last one. Gotta finish this.
That's the last of them. Guess your days of setting ambushes around here are over. All right, let's see if they got an underground bunker around here.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's the Wild West again. And some men are acting like law and order are a thing of the past. But last I checked, this is still the United States of America. And in America, the right of property shall not be infringed. We have the right to claim territory, to hold it, and to defend it. Sure, we took this land from the Indians. No point in rewriting history, but we took it by force. And force is the only thing that will move us now. We're not gonna roll over for a bunch of bullies. If the feds, or rippers, or marauders think they're gonna come rolling into my wilderness, they got another thing coming. The strongest survive. The strongest take, and the strongest will succeed. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Listen to Cope, law and order are a thing of the past. What are you talking about? But yeah, you got a point about force being the only thing that matters now. Force and a lot of goddamn ammo.